Привет, Москва. It's our and me our honor to introduce you to the world premiere of the Shadow Tonnetz. What means Tonnetz? This is a German word, Tonnetz. It is a network of tones. Imagine that with mathematics, you will catch the tones and represent them in a network. Of course, we will begin with the simplest we can make. He was not only famous for inventing the cat flap or discovering gravity, he was the first to associate chromatism in terms of colors on musical notes. He was the greatest alchemist of his time. He also added planets and chemical symbols to his chromatic circle. There were only seven notes in use, Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol. I will expand his idea for our 12-tone system. Yes, it looks very familiar. We can match the notes onto a clock. Once we reach 11, the next is 0. We call this in mathematics the cyclic group Z12. I know you love stories. We've seen Newton, then Leonhard Euler, the father of graph theory, the Königsberg-Bruckner problem, was at the same time working on musical path and created the first 2D Tonnetz. The modern version of the Tonnetz came with Arthur von Oettingen, and was popularized by Hugo Riemann. Then other theories that have enhanced Riemann's idea. This is called the Neo Riemannian theory. The Shadow Tonnetz is the latest of my enhancements of the Neo Riemannian Tonnetz. I began to add colors to the standard version. Then, with fellow math musicians, we added functions for analyzing music. This evolution is the subject of my movie. When we have two parameters, we can in mathematics associate them with two dimensions. For instance, x function of y can be drawn in a plane. Here, two parameters are color and shape. Color varies along one axis and shape on the other. You know, like road signs that have shape and color variation. Here comes a big question. Three shapes and four colors. There are, yes, 12 unique symbols that will match the notes parameters. Seems strange, but since dimension is a parameter, mathematicians can use this concept. We can divide a set of notes in three groups of four, the three diminished chords. We can also divide a set of notes in four groups of three, the four augmented chords. Each note belongs to one diminished chord, a square, and one augmented chord, a triangle. These are the two parameters, square number and triangle number. We associate the triangle number to a shape, and we associate the square number to a color. By matching the note on 2D colors, we obtain 12 unique symbols. We have been ordering the notes in a chromatic way, Do, Do dièse, Re, Mi. There is another way to do it, like adding a fifth at each time, Do, Sol, Re, La, Mi. The system, of course, will work on the circle of fifth. In mathematics, we say that 1 and 5 are generators of V12. I've showed networks of notes. We will now build chords networks. Thank you. You would ask me, is there any musician who would draw such a path in a Tonnetz and a hexagon? Maybe we'll see it later. The Tonnetz with chords is also infinite. The notes are in the center of the hexagons. On the notes we will find the chords major and minor chords. The colorized Tonnetz is an extension of the traditional Tonnetz. In this part of the Ninth Symphony, our national anthem, Beethoven uses a regular path. This path goes through each major and minor chord. We call it an Hamiltonian path. Why didn't Beethoven close the loop? He didn't need to do that, he was a genius. He just shown it is possible. And musically, it is also better for the transition. This is the hypersphere of chords. It lives in a 4D space. We can embed any Tonnetz on the hypersphere. This is not the topic of this movie. You will find all the details on my website, mathemusic.net. After colorization, we will now perform polarization. This has been invented by H.Seress. There are three directions: relative, C major to A minor, parallel, C major to C minor, and leading tone, C major to E minor. They are mathematically equivalent, but not musically. Each will receive a specific color. These relations can be from major to minor or the other way around, from minor to major. This is called the modal orientation. At last, the intensity differs between each transformation. The intensity depends on the change on the key signature, the number of sharps or flats. Orange for adding sharps or pink for adding flats. Let's recap. Direction, modal orientation, and intensity. intense color will be used for gray signature change, gray when there is no change, for instance, A minor to C major. The polarized Tonnetz is also infinite. By adding my coloration to Hugo's Tonnetz, we made the polarized Tonnetz. When moving in the Tonnetz, we may choose particular directions. For instance, this is a dominant root. Now, the same root in the other direction. We will not cover all directions here. It's available in our publication on mathemusic.net. Spinnen means spider in German or Ji Zhu in Chinese. Usually the harmony tends to come back home. This is called the tonal attraction. We can use some direct root without following the Tonnetz, or we follow the Tonnetz. Or just imagine a path to demonstrate some musical properties. Thank you. When we first met in Belgrade, Ilda had the idea or the wish to keep trace of the harmonic path. With the Shadow Tonnetz, the moving ball draws a trace on the network. As in a sound, the trace will be light if the pass is seldom used, or deep if the harmonic sequence is very employed at this time. Please note how the spider web will remain in position, tonal attraction, and Tchaikovsky will make us travel and visit all dominants. Here, Prokofiev will make use of the Tonal Center. cannot represent music without hearing or visualizing. Спасибо. До свидания.